Manti Te'o says he stuck to the story about a girlfriend he'd never met, briefly telling the media and the public about her, even when he knew something was wrong. In an interview with ABC's Katie Couric, Te'o was asked why.
This girl who I committed myself to died on September 12th. Now I get a phone call on December 6th saying that she's alive, and then I'm going to be put on national TV 2 days later, and they ask me about the same question. You know, what would you do?
A source with knowledge of the matter tells CNN a woman pretending to be Te'o's apparent girlfriend, Lene Kakua, called him on December 6th, claiming she had faked her death because she was afraid of drug dealers. Te'o went to Notre Dame officials with the story. The school investigated and, according to our source, confirmed that two men and a woman were behind the hoax. Te'o said he didn't believe that his online girlfriend never existed until Deadspin.com first reported it on January 16th. Now, the woman who says her Facebook pictures were used to depict the fictional girlfriend on Twitter has told NBC News she wasn't part of the hoax and never met Manti Te'o. Diane O'Meara says this man, Ronaya Tuiasosopo, an acquaintance from high school, is behind the scheme.
The past 5 years, he's literally been stalking my Facebook and stealing my photos.
O'Meara said Tuiasosopo called her, confessed, and apologized. Manti Te'o and Deadspin say Tuiasosopo is behind the hoax. CNN's source says Notre Dame's investigation has confirmed that he was one of the people behind it. CNN has tried several times to reach Ronaya Tuiasosopo. He has not responded. His father, Titus, a pastor whose picture is here on Facebook, would not go on camera with us, but did tell us, quote, "The truth will all come out. God knows our character." Te'o has denied being part of the hoax. I asked crisis management expert Eric Desenhall about the Couric interview.
What would you do?
How did he come across to you?
You know, there's a difference between being young and foolish and being Machiavellian and scheming. He comes across as a guy who probably is young and foolish. Now, we don't know what the data trail is going to show. That remains to be seen.
And in fact, some key questions remain. Did Manti Te'o and Ronaya Tuiasosopo know each other before all this broke? A distant cousin of Ronaya Tuiasosopo's told me that the families do know each other, but we've not gotten any details beyond that. Another key question, who is the person posing as Teo's girlfriend, who Te'o says he spoke to on the phone many times? Answers we are still digging on.